This video will cover the page 4 of the end of year paper. So if you look at question 8, they gave you a speed time graph and they are asking you to find out where or when does the car is moving in a decreasing acceleration. So since you are finding acceleration in a speed time graph, you must know that the acceleration is given by the gradient of your speed time graph. So if you want decreasing acceleration, you can turn this word into decreasing gradient, since that is what you are looking for. So decreasing gradient meaning that the curve should get more and more gentle. So if you look here, this is the beginning of the curve. It is this steep. By the end of it, the gradient become a flat line. So we know that decreasing gradient happen between 1 to 1.5. Okay, for your Q9, they gave you a different graph. This is displacement time. It is different from speed time. Okay, so for your displacement time, you need to know that the gradient of your displacement time actually give you velocity. So to describe its motion, you need to look at the gradient. So if you look at car Y, your gradient is simply zero because it's flat. You look at car X, at the beginning the gradient is extremely steep and towards the end it is almost flat. So we say that this one, it is decreasing gradient. And for Z, you need to pay special attention because it is negative gradient, right? And this gradient is changing from very steep to gentle. So in this case, car Z is also decreasing gradient. So once you work out the gradient, all you need to do now is to change the word gradient to velocity. So you can slash this velocity, you can slash this velocity, you can slash this velocity. So once you have this in mind, this table becomes a matching game. You just need to match. So let's look at car Y first, because I got a sensing that car Y is easiest. So car Y, it is not constant velocity but zero velocity. So zero velocity simply means that it is not moving. So I know that it is just between B and D. Next thing I will look at is my car X. So let's look at car X. I have decreasing velocity. So therefore, I should have this and not this. So just by looking at X and Y, I can select B. But just to be for the purpose of this revision video, let's look at this. So for X and Y, both of these velocity is positive. But for Z, you can see that the gradient is negative and hence the velocity is negative. In kinematic, we say that basically the direction of motion basically is reflected by the sine of your velocity. So in this case, this means that at the earlier at car X and Y, it is moving in the positive direction, but for your car Z, it's actually moving backwards in an opposite direction. So because of that, you can see that car Z is moving in opposite direction against car X. So because of that, you can actually see that for your option B, all three of them are correct options. So it is special here because I need more likes and subscriptions so that I can upload more video. I'm reaching my limit soon. So if you can, please click the like and subscribe button. Thank you.